Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. For this video, I wanted to share just a quick reflection just about something that I've been thinking about during lockdown and feel like lockdown has taught us. So this video is all about gifts and how the church has adapted to life during lockdown. If you enjoy this video, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below to see more videos from me and Arnold. And if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, please do let me know down in the comments. Romans 12, verses 4 to 8 says, "For just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts, according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully." So during the last 12 weeks of lockdown, it's been really interesting to see how the body of Christ and the church has adapted to this new environment that we're living in lockdown. This is a natural process that we see in animals all over the world. African elephants have big ears that they can flap to cool themselves down in the hot climates that they live in. Polar bears, on the other hand, have a thick layer of fur to keep them warm in their much colder homes. Giraffes have long necks so they can reach food right at the top of the trees. And penguins have webbed feet and streamlined flippers to help them swim at high speeds underwater. And in the same way, lockdown has presented the church with a whole new environment that we have needed to adapt to. An environment where we cannot meet together, where we cannot use our church buildings, where the difference between those that have internet and technology and those that don't is amplified. A place where some of our members have to shield themselves away from everyone else. And I think we've adapted well because of the gifts that God has given to us. I have seen people using their gifts of filming videos and editing videos to help put our services together. We've seen Isaac and Rachel using their gifts of creativity and music to put together a song that we could all sing and play together virtually. We've seen people who are usually wary of technology master Zoom calls so that they can run their house group or attend morning prayer. Some of these are skills that we haven't seen before. And some of them are skills that we know people had, but they are utilised in a different way to suit the situation that we're facing. Personally, I feel that I've been able to use my gifts in teaching that I would usually use as an occasional preacher to create different kinds of teaching on YouTube videos. And it's thanks to these different gifts and skills that we have been able to adapt to the situation that we're facing. God has equipped his church to continue serving him and serving our community, no matter what we're facing. But we also need to look ahead and think about what these gifts and skills mean as church begins to return to some form of normal. When we don't need our services to be filmed and edited, when we're not using Zoom for all of our different meetings, we know that each person in the body of Christ, and therefore each person in all of our churches, has a vital role to play in the functioning of this body, and that each of us has gifts given to us by God. And we are called to use these gifts, to lead diligently, and to give generously. So these gifts that we've discovered in lockdown, how are we going to make sure that we keep using them, even though they're not obviously needed anymore? As the body of Christ, we all have a role to play in encouraging others to use their gifts and helping them to grow and develop in those gifts. So I want to encourage all of us to notice these gifts that we're seeing during lockdown, to remember them, to be praying over them, and to keep encouraging those people even as church begins to return to normal.